Welcome to another Glacial Geek Battle Report. I am Phil, the Glacial Geek, and today my Dark Angels will be taking on Colin's Astra Militarum. So the story is that there was a planet that got sick and tired of sending its daughters and sons off to the meat grinder that is the Imperial Guard, and got sick and tired of having to meet the quotas for sending off food to other planets when their own people were starving. So they decided they no longer had to meet the quotas. So they no longer had to do it. So the Imperium, of course, disagreed and sent in the Dark Angels to go convince them otherwise. So today, the Astra Militarum will actually be playing the role of Planetary Defense Force, and they will be trying to hold off the initial forces of the Dark Angels come in to tell them, no, you do have to give us your food. So that's the story of our battle that's going on here. We've landed out in the outskirts of their settlement, so they've got a little bit of a defensive position here that the Dark Angels are trying to overtake. So that's how it goes. So we'll go and show you the two armies and the psychic powers, and then we'll come back to you with the start of the game. For the Dark Angels, I'll be running a Lion's Blade Strike Force and a Combined Arms Detachment. So to start with the Lion's Blade Strike Force, we'll start with the Demi-Company portion of this. It'll be led by a Company Master with a Power Sword and a Combi Plasma. We have a 10-man tactical squad with a Meltagun, a Plasma Cannon, and a Rhino as a dedicated transport. We have another 10-man tactical squad with a Plasma Cannon, a Flamer, and a Rhino as a dedicated transport. We have another 10-man tactical squad with a Flamer and a Plasma Cannon. We have a 5-man assault squad, and the Sergeant has a Power Maul. And to finish off the Demi Company, we have a 5-man Devastator squad with 4 Las Cannons. To complete the Lion's Blade Strike Force, we have a Raven Wing Attack Squadron. So here we have a 3-man Raven Wing squad with a Plasma Gun and an Attack Bike with a Multimelta. And we have a Land Speeder with a Heavy Flamer instead of a Heavy Bolter. That'll complete the Raven Wing Attack Squadron and the Lion's Blade Strike Force. For the Combined Arms Attachment, we have leading it a Level 2 Librarian with a Force Axe. For troops, we have 2 5-man scout squads with camo cloaks and sniper rifles. We have a 3-man Raven Wing squad with a plasma gun. And last but not least, we have a Whirlwind. So for the Astra Militarum, we have a company command squad with a Master of Ordnance, 2 plasma guns, and a las cannon with a Chimera as a dedicated transport. As a second HQ choice, we have a company command squad with 2 plasma guns, a las cannon, and a Chimera as a dedicated transport. We have an infantry platoon squad with a platoon command squad with a plasma gun, 2 grenade launchers, and 2 infantry squads with a missile launcher in each. We have 4 Bulgarin with grenadier gauntlets and slab shields. We have a priest. We have 3 level 1 Primaris Psykers. We have a Lehman Russ Demolisher. We have a Lehman Russ main battle tank. And last but not least, we have a Wyvern. And for the Dark Angel's psychic powers, he rolled on Enteromancy, so he gets Mind Worm as the Primaris power. Then he got Seed of Fear and Maelstrom of Misery. Alright, psychic powers for the Astra Militarum. These two psychers rolled on Divination, so they each get Prescience. The one on the left also rolled and got Misfortune. The one on the right rolled and got Foreboding. Then this guy, he rolled on Telekinesis, so he gets Assail as the Primaris power, and then rolled and got Telekine Dome. Alright, so here's the, those are the armies. Here is the deployment for the Astra Militarum. We've got a command squad over here in a Chimera. We've got the main battle tank there. We've got a whole bunch of troops there along the gun line there. We've got the Wyvern in the back. This is the other command squad with the Warlord inside, so they've also got the Master of Ordnance inside. Going over here, we have another platoon command squad is inside of the bunker there. The other platoon command squad's over on this side, over this side. And then we've got over here, we've got the Demolisher with a line of Bulgarin, basically acting like a moving Aegis line in the front there, with one of the Psykers and the Priest giving them Zealot, moving up this way. We've got another Psyker in there, and the third Psyker is right up front here. So that's the deployment for Astra Militarum. Over here for the Dark Angels, we have the tactical squads all split into combat squads. So we've got a combat squad, a tactical squad over here. with a plasma cannon. We've got the Ravenwing attack squadron here with the Ravenwing there with the attack bike, and then the land speeder up there behind them. We've got another combat squadded tactical squad there with a plasma cannon. We've got a Rhino here. Inside that Rhino is a combat squadded tactical squad with a flamer and a sergeant, and also the level 2 librarian is inside there. We've got the assault squad. We've got a combat squadded tactical squad with a flamer and a sergeant. We've got the other Ravenwing squad there. Inside that Rhino is a combat squadded tactical squad with a melt-a-gun, a sergeant, and the company commander. We have our Devastator squad there. We got some scouts scattered up there. Scouts scattered up here. We got our Whirlwind back here. And we got a combat squadded tactical squad with the plasma cannon there. So that's the deployment. As of right now, Astra Militarum is going to go first. So I'm going to try to roll to seize the initiative. I do not. So close. It's a whole lot of pips on there, but not enough. One short. All right, so Astra Militarum will go first. There is knight fighting first turn. So we'll come back to you after movement phase for the Astra Militarum. All right, so end of movement phase for Astra Militarum. His tank's kind of moved up here. This guy right here actually mobilized himself on that crater there, so he lost a hull point and is immobilized. The Wyvern kind of moved up. These guys in the line stood still, but the guys behind the line moved up and ready to take their place. These guys over here started moving up, and that's the end of the movement phase for them. So then we move on to psychic phase. He rolled a 3, leaving me with 5 dice and leaving him with 6. So the first thing he's going to try to do is...
He's going to cast prescience
on the Lemon Russ.
Does not
go off. All right.
Go for a Telekine Dome over here.
And then we're going to go on Telekine Dome over here, needing 2.
Got it.
Who gets it? I'm going to roll to try to deny it. And I do not. All right, so that goes off. So they've got Telekine Dome, which is a 5+ invul for him and anyone within 12 inches of him. So that whole group gets 5+ invul. So that's pretty nice. All right, so now we're going to move on to the shooting phase for Astra Militarum in turn 1.
9+.
All right, so here we go. We're going to move on to actually the orders here for Astra Militarum. I forgot about that because I've never played them myself. So the group inside here, the command squad inside, is going to actually cast Fire on my target. So I need a 9 or under. Cocked. Perfect. It goes off. So they've got fire on my target. And this group here is also going to show his fire on my target. So need a 9 or under. That goes off. Cool. Perfect. So that's the orders phase. And now we'll move on to the shooting phase.
Yeah, I'm going to
shoot. All right. So this guy over here with the Master of Ordnance is going to drop big old pie plate right on top of them. So let's see the scatter dice. It's an error.
12, 15, minus 4, 12.
Yep, minus 15. So it moves 12 inches this way. So that's pretty big scatter.
Yeah.
I think it's probably going to, actually it might scatter right there onto my scouts. Should be kind of brutal. Yep, right there catches a couple of scouts. So
two
scouts. So you want to roll that?
Anything but.
Oop, so one, and it ignores cover?
Yep,
because he's got the, so closest dies. Boom. All right, so now we got it, the other squad's going to...
Last cannon.
Oh, last cannon into here.
That's a miss. Okay.
And that should be it for that squad, so moving on to the shooting phase. So now he's going to fire his last cannon into here. It's the squad inside of these chimeras.
That's a hit.
Front 11, so 2 is a glance. All right, no intervening cover, so he'll just take a hull point. All right, moving on. All right, the battle tank, this guy over here, is going to fire his big old blast on there. So, rolling. Scatters 8 inches, minus how many?
3.
Minus 3, so 5 inches. So that'll just land on my squad there. So it'll get all 5 of the assault guys. All right, it's going to roll. Strength 8, so wounded on 2s. Oh, what's the AP?
3.
AP 3? Oh, so that's 4 guys dead, huh? Boom. That was brutal. Alright, moving on. Alright, gonna snap fire the heavy bolters into him. So hitting on 6s? Nope. Alright, moving on.
Let's do...
These missile launch guys are gonna fire crack missiles into that rhino there. So needing 4+. 2 hits. 8 on 11, so need 3s. 2 pens. All right, see what they are. It's wrecked regardless, but nope. So it's just a wreck. So first blood goes to Astra Militarum. All right, the demolisher cannon from there. It's going to fire over here. So it scatters over a whole bunch. 5 inches. So looking over, 5 inches. Does that hit anybody?
Yeah, just that one guy.
Just hits the one guy over there. So
anything but.
Hits. Yep, hits. So I get a four plus cover save. Nope. So he dies. All right. So moving on. All right. Now the Wyvern is going to fire over onto my scouts here. So the first shot scatters 7 inches, or scatters 4 inches. So that's off back over there. So now let's see. Oof, back the other way. Back this way. So that hits one guy. And it'll hit two. So it gets 2 hits.
4 against 4.
4 on 4. So strength, yeah, toughness 4. So strength 4, toughness 4, looking for 4s. 2 hits. And what's the AP on that?
6.
6. So now I've got to see AP 6. So they've got ignores cover. So I've got two 4 plus armor saves. All right, one guy dies. Closest to him is that. Cool. All right, moving on. End of the shooting phase there for the Astra Militarum. These guys failed their leadership test and ran back 7 inches, but he was held his ground. So now we'll move on and come back to you after the end of movement phase for Dark Angels on turn one. All right, this is psychic phase movement phase for Dark Angels. These guys moved up here, these guys moved up here, these guys moved up here. Whole bunch of movement. Moving along, those guys stood still, these guys stood still. Everyone else just kind of stood still. So that's the end of the movement phase for Dark Angels. Move on to the psychic phase. I rolled a 3, leaving with 5 dice. So he's gonna try to cast Maelstrom of Misery, which I'm gonna be casting over on those guys. So need 2. I get it with 3. That's all my dice, so you probably wanna just throw them all in there.
5 plus?
Yep, 5 plus, because of the psyker in the unit.
One.
Just one. All right, so it goes off. So it's a focus witchfire, so we'll get back to you with the results of that. All right, so the result of that psychic power was that I hit, and it landed direct hit 3 guys, and then didn't wound anyone. So, womp womp. All right, moving on to the shooting phase for Dark Angels. This squad of bikers is going to fire on the Chimera there. The only weapons that can hurt it are the one plasma gun and the one multi-melta. So black will be the multi-melta, green will be the plasma gun. Both hitting on 3s. Both hit. Glancing on a 5 on the green, 4 on the black. Okay, fair enough. Good rolling. Way to go. All right, moving on. All right, so the plasma gun in this squad is going to fire on the Chimera there. So I got to roll gets hot. And he does get hot, of course. 3 plus for armor save. Okay, he's good, but he's not going to do anything. So this guy is going to fire on the Chimera there. So gets hot. Nope, he's good. So I'm going to place it right there. Yeah, do you want to hold that there? Cool. Rolling for a scatter. Oof. -4, so 6 inches. Yeah, that's going to be off. I don't think it's hitting anybody. Cool. All right, so that's that. Moving on. All right, moving over here, these snipers are going to shoot into the Ogryn squad there. So I need 3s to hit with my new ballistic skill 4 snipers. Ooh, all right. We got a bunch of, they're all precision hits. So I'm actually going to place them on your psyker. So they're going to go on the psyker. He can look at Sir normally, but just think he's going to have to do that. So wounding on 4s. And 6s are rending. So 2 rending shots on him or on whoever. So do you want to look out, Sir? All right, so two pluses. Do one. Nope. He's going to take 1. And then 1 gets looked at, sir.
Okay, and they're both, I got Telekine Dome for a 5 up.
All right, so we'll do the one first on the Psyker because the Telekine Dome. So the Psyker first, 5 plus. Nope. So he takes AP 2 shot, and then on the other guy.
Yep.
He does, so he gets saved. So the Psyker takes 1 wound. How many does he have?
2.
He has 2, so he's down to 1. All right, not bad, snipers. Moving on. All right, last cannon guys are going to fire into the Bulgrin there. So hitting on 3s. Okay, all but 1. And then wounding on 2s.
I'll get this chick out of my hand.
Okay, all wound. They've got, 5 plus invul? All right, 3 5 plus invuls. One save, so two wounds on the closest guy. So the closest guy is going to die. Where it is.
Closest guy.
Yep, sounds good.
Two wounds?
Yeah, three two. Wound, oh, they're three wound models. Oh, okay, so he's not dead. So he's down to one. Yep. All right, well played. All right, moving on. All right, the squad inside the rhino is going to shoot on them. So I've got a melted gun, which is going to be the black one, and a rapid-firing bolter, which is going to be the green. So hitting on sixes because he moved 12.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Nope, nothing. All right, so moving on. All right, this squad here is going to fire into these guys. So I got three twin link bolt guns, because I'm going to fire the guy with the plasma gun is going to fire his bike mounted gun. So hitting on threes, twin linked. All right, wounding on, what's their toughness? Three?
Three.
So wounding on threes. Okay, one wound. So they've got a 4+ cover save or armor
four
save?
Plus
or?
With knife fighting.
Oh, yeah, sorry, 3+.
Still
no, still a guy. So just the closest guy. Probably be one of those guys. Oh, man. All right. So I think that's going to be all. Oh, no. I've still got him to go. So, yep. Moving on to this guy.
Don't forget that.
Yeah, I know. I can't forget that one. Nobody wants to forget the huge gun. So I'm going to put it right there if I can. So I'm going to put it right on the middle of the guy there. So coming over here. Getting my scatter die, rolling for a scatter. Ooh, minus three. So how many does that hit? Two guys, three guys? Four, I don't know, four.
Two bases.
Does it hit two bases? I think it hit like
that one and that one. Okay,
maybe that guy?
That,
yeah. Yeah, so three guys. So hits three, strength four, AP five, ignores cover. Strength four, toughness three, so one. So his one. Yep. So it took out one. All right. Way to go, Whirlwind. All right. Moving on. Actually, I think that's the end of my shooting phase. I'll have a couple guys are running, but that's boring to watch, so I'm not going to put that on film. So we'll come back to you after movement phase for the Astra Militarum. All right. So movement phase for Astra Militarum on turn two. This guy kind of shuffled back a bit. These guys kind of all shuffled around a bit, looking to get different positions. These guys moved up. He just kind of pivoted to make sure he doesn't give side armor to those guys. So that's the movement phase for Astra Militarum. Now we're going to move into the psychic phase. He rolled a four, so leaving me with six dice, leaving him with seven dice. And now he's going to try to cast Misfortune from him onto this unit here with my librarian in it. So he needs, how many war charges do you need?
Two.
So he's rolling four dice. Does not get it. Oh no. All right. So now we move on to, he's going to do Telekine Dome on those guys. And that goes, does not go off. All right. So rough psychic phase there. So that's the end of the psychic phase. We'll come back to you the shooting phase and starting off with orders. All right, so starting here, we're gonna do first rank fire, second rank fire on these guys. Need a nine, goes off. Now we're gonna do fire on my target with the squad inside of the Chimera there. Need less than nine, goes off. And then on to these guys over here, need nine or less. Oop.
Come on, baby.
Roll up. Nine, exactly, perfect. All right, so they're gonna be ignoring cover. They're gonna be ignoring cover. And all these dudes along here are going to be firing an extra las cannon shot, a las gun shot. So we'll see how that goes. All right, we'll come back to you with the shooting phase. So these guys here with the first rank fire, second rank fire are going to be firing on that dude there. So we've got 28 las gun shots with that coming off. So verse 14, hitting on fours. Not bad. All right. Want to roll those just to with the wounds, then we can just roll again. So what's the strength?
Three,
so wounded on fives. So we've got three wounds. All right, roll those again. I'll just remember three. Remember three, people. So hitting on fours.
Okay.
Everything else was a miss. All right, wounded on fives, plus another two. So that's a five total. Because remember, we remembered three. So five total.
Yep.
All right. So I will get five armor saves, five 3+s. Can he do it? Nope, he can't. By one. All right, so that's another kill point there for you. All right, moving on. All right, we're gonna do fire my target from here. So the Master of Ordnance is gonna drop his big old pie plate right on my squad there. Oop, that's gonna be scooting off.
Ooh, no, it's not.
No, it's not. 3 inches. Perfect. All right, so that hits four of the guys. Yep, four of them in there. So you want to roll that? Four strength. What is it?
Nine.
Strength nine. So anything but ones. All right, so that's four. AP what?
AP three.
AP three. Ugh. Is it ordnance?
Yes.
Ugh. So these four guys. Well, he takes.
He can look out.
He can look out, sir. So I got one guy. Well, it's right on him, right?
Right.
So four. Two pluses. All right, so he's gonna have to take one. So he'll take one wound, and then three other guys will die. All right. Wow, that was pretty devastating. All right, and then the last cannon shot.
On a three.
On a three, hits. One on two. That wound right there. So, wow. All right. So they're going to be making the test for leadership. Wah, wah. All right. So the squad inside here is also going to shoot on this poor, poor squad. What do they ever do to you? So we're going to shoot the plasma gun first. All right. Misses, but didn't get hot. And then the last cannon hits. Went on two. Wounds. So, burp. All right. Then we're going to do the multi-laser and the heavy bolter. So heavy bolter first, or multi-late, which, I don't know how many they do. What do they do? Are they threes?
Yeah, they're
three. They're three shots each?
Yeah. Three right. Under heavy bolter.
All right, three and under heavy bolter. So three heavy bolter. So three heavy bolter shots hit.
Whoops, five against a four.
Five on a four, so looking for threes.
Two wounds.
Two wounds. I roll those. Oh, one dead. That's one miss, that's all it took. So he's dead. Wow, two more kill points right there. All right, moving along. So here we go. This big old gun, the main battle tank, is going to shoot on here. It's going to actually put it right over top of him. So that'll actually hit three guys from the squad and then give one shot onto the to there. So, oh, scattering off. Ooh, quite a bit. 7 inches. I think it hits one guy.
Okay.
So,
eight. Strength eight.
Eight on five, so two that hits. AP three.
Yep.
So that's ordnance, so he's gone. All right, so move, and then three snap fire and heavy boulders. Three shots, nope. So, all right, moving on. He's gonna fire his demolisher cannon right onto these guys here. Does it ignore cover?
No, it does not.
Then they're gonna jink.
Okay.
So, hit. Direct hit, so that'll hit, what, two guys, three guys in that squad? And the
yeah, it does clip that.
Does good. So three guys in the bike squad plus one on the scout squad. So do the one on the scout squad. Anything but.
But. Oh,
yeah, it was a butt. I got the butt. All right, on these guys, anything but. Here's a strength 10.
Two.
So two. All right, two, four plus jinx saves. Reroll because of Ravenwing being awesome.
Yes.
No. So one guy died. All right. It was on the center because it's ordnance, right? Is it ordnance?
It is ordnance.
It is ordnance. All right. So there he goes. All right. Well played. Moving on. All right. This squad of Bulgarin are going to fire on these guys. They've got these blast shots. So first shot is direct hit. How many is that hit?
Three.
Next shot.
Three.
Hit. Direct hit. So that's also three.
Same thing.
That's going off. On. And then another shot. That's going to be off. So we got six hits on them. So strength what?
Four.
Strength four, toughness four. So we're looking for fours. All right, so we got four hits in there. All right. Can I roll those? Four plus saves. Oh, what?
Wow.
All right.
Wow.
Way to go, jerks. All right, so that was super effective. All right, moving on. All right, and last but not least on the shooting phase, we got the Wyvern shooting on these guys. So first one, scattering 2 inches. So it'll be there, it'll hit, how many is that? One?
Just one.
Just one, right?
Starting from here.
Starting from there, direct hit, so they can go hit all five, or three more? All right, so we're at four so far. I'll miss. Another what?
Three.
Another three? So we're at seven?
Yep.
All right, so seven hits on these guys right here. So strength?
Four.
Strength four, toughness four, looking for fours?
Rerolling
because it's shred?
Yep, ignore cover.
And ignores cover? But it's not AP3, so no. They should be good. All right, so three wounds the first round.
Six.
Ooh, another three, so six total. All right.
Full.
Grab my dice. Armor saves of 3+. Lose two of them. All right. All right. So that's the end of the shooting phase. I've got a couple leadership tests to make, and then we'll come back to you after movement phase. There's nobody no charges, right? No charges. So we'll come back to you after movement phase for the Dark Angels on turn two. All right. So end of movement phase for Dark Angels on turn two. These guys kind of shuffled up this way, looking over this way. Those guys ran back across the river because they had fallen back because they're a bunch of jerks. Those guys moved around over this way, looking on them. This kind of shuffled around, looking on them. They just kind of stayed still. These guys ran up a bit. So we'll see if I'm moving up a little closer. So that's the end of movement phase. I've got no psychers left since my psyker died. So we're just going to move straight into the shooting phase. This squad is going to shoot into the front of this chimera over here. So the black will be the multi-melta. The green will be the plasma. So hitting on threes. Both hit. The green is wounding on fives, glancing on fives. Black is glancing on fours. All right, so got one glance. So he takes one glance. All right, moving on in the shooting phase. All right, so this plasma gunner here, plasma cannon here, is going to fire right onto him there. So it gets hot. Nope, doesn't get hot. So now roll for scatter. So it's hit. So it's direct hit. So we got one hit. Front is 12, so glancing on a 5. Oh. It's a pen! All right. What's the result? Plus 1. 6, it's immobilized. All right, not bad. Way to go, plasma cannoner. He's down to 1 hull point and immobilized. All right, moving on. All right, so the squad inside of the rhino there is going to fire into the bolt gun over there. So I've got a rapid firing bolt gun and a melta gun. So hitting on threes. Oh, of course. So I got one hit. Toughness 5. So wounding on a 5. Nothing. All right, and I'm going to fire the storm bolter from the rhino, hitting on threes, wounding on a 5, one wound, but you got a 3+ armor save, he's good. All right, moving on. All right, so this bike squad is going to fire into the bullgren over there. So I've got a rapid firing plasma gun, which will be the green, a rapid firing bolt gun, which will be the black. So hitting on threes, all hit. So the greens are wounding on twos, the blacks are wounding on fives. Okay, so I've got 2 AP2 hit wounds and nothing of that. So 2 AP2 wounds on those guys. Do they have an invul save for the slab?
Nope.
All right, so 2 wounds on the closest guy to that squad. So another guy down to 1. All right, so moving on in the shooting phase. These sniper guys are going to fire into these guys. So hitting on threes. I've got 2 hits. One of them's a precision shot, so I'm going to do that on the psyker. So the black will be the precision shot on the sniper, on the psyker, and the green will just be a regular shot. Wounded on fours. Okay. Right. That's how this is going. All right. Moving on. All right. So the whirlwind is going to fire his big old pie plate over this way. So they're going to do the strength 4 AP5 ignores cover. So, looking for a scatter, direct hit. So, how many is that? It's a whole lot of guys, huh?
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. 9 regular guys and a psyker.
Alright. Alright, so we got 10. 10 hits on there. I could really use this. Alright, so we got 10. 10 shots coming in, wounding on threes.
Yep. There it is.
So, all right, so we got 9 hits, and I don't think it's ordnance. I'm gonna check and see if it's ordnance. All right, so we it is ordnance, and it was centered right on the psyker guy there. So we've got 9 lookout sirs. Okay, so 2 don't, so it's, what's his armor?
He's dead.
Oh, he's dead, okay, so he's dead. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 more guys are dead. Wow, that was pretty effective. That's like the first thing that my army's done that was effective. All right, so we'll move on in the shooting phase. All right, turns out he has a refractor field. So he's got 2 5+, because those are the only 2 that hit him. And he saved him. That's how you do it. That's how you do it. That's why he's a primary psyker. But 7 other guys did get killed, so. All right, so that's that. Moving on in the shooting phase. The lone sniper there is gonna fire into these guys. So hitting on a three. Nope, he misses. All right, so we're moving on to the four Laz Cannon guys. They're also going to fire into the Bulgarin there. So hitting on threes. All right, three shots, wounded on twos. Three wounds, AP two. So, boom, one guy dead. Yeah. All right, moving on. All right, I lied. Nothing more really for the Dark Angels this turn. These guys kind of ran up. These guys kind of ran up. And these guys kind of ran up. So that's about it for the Dark Angels turn. So we'll come back to you after movement phase for Astra Militarum on turn three. All right, movement for Astra Militarum. These guys kind of shuffled up here. He kind of shuffled up a bit. These guys just kind of made themselves incoherency, moving along the trenches in here. These guys are immobilized, so they can't move anywhere. So now we're going to move on to the psychic phase. He rolled a one, and I think he's going to try to cast Misfortune on my bikers here. So needing two. No, not getting it. You've had bad luck with the psychic phase. That's the only bad luck you've had, but you've had bad luck with the psychic phase. All right, so that's the end of the psychic phase. We'll come back to you with shooting phase and start with the orders for Astra Militarum on turn three. All right, the command squad inside here is going to do fire on my target, needing a nine or less. Getting it? Wow, they are really, really getting it. And then these guys are going to roll for fire on my target as well. Yep, they're good too. Wow, really strong. All right, so those two units are going to ignore cover. So moving on to the shooting phase. All right, so we realized when he first rolled this, he rolled double ones, which is inspired leadership. So these guys actually also got first rank fire, second rank fire because of that, because it automatically passes, and these guys didn't actually have to roll for this, so this automatically passed afterwards. So that's the end of the orders phase. So now moving on into the shooting phase. All right, Master of Ordnance is going to fire from here onto these guys, placing the big old blast right on top of my sergeant there. So it scatters 6 inches, because he's got, you can see him. So 6 inches off of them. That probably doesn't hit anybody. Nope, doesn't hit anyone. All right, but then he's got still got a last cannon coming from that squad. So that doesn't hit. All right. So moving on. All right, these guys are going to shoot their las guns into my scouts over here. So the first 12, because he's got first rank fire, second rank fire, hitting on fours.
Seven
hits. All right, second roll. Hitting on fours.
10.
Wow.
14.
Wow, 14. That is some brutal, brutal rolling there. All right, and then it's strength what?
Three.
Strength three, toughness four, so wounded on fives. That is some good rolling there.
Turn that one.
Yeah, yeah, I think so.
Yeah, so.
So that's eight.
All right.
So we've got eight armor saves. So eight armor saves of four or better. One, two, three. They're dead. That's exactly what I needed to die. All right. So that's another kill point. No more scouts. Well, I got one more scout, but then that squad. All right, moving on. All right, the squad in here is going to shoot on him. I can't jink. Well, I can jink, but he's going to ignore cover anyway. So we've got two plasma shots and a las cannon shots hitting on threes. Okay, so just one plasma shot. Oh, was that a one? No, that was a two. All right, so now it's seven on ten, so need a three to glance. Six, it's a pen. So you want to roll that pen? Plus two, plus one. So three, I think it's shaken. So he's got a wound and he's shaken. Moving on. All right, now the Chimera is going to fire into him. It doesn't have ignore cover, so I will be jinking on this. So we've got three, which is the gray, which are the heavy bolters, and the blues are the multi-laser. So
needing fours.
Needing fours. Okay, wow, nice.
So five.
So five on these.
Well, what's your?
10, so strength five, yeah, so five. It needs fives. Glance, one. Got one pen.
Strength six.
Strength six, so needs fours to glance. So another pen. So I need, so four plus jinx save. Reroll because of Raven Wing. Yeah! Yeah, reroll! Ha ha! And that's the turning of the tide. Just kidding, probably not. But moving on in the shooting phase. Yep, so these guys are gonna fire into here. He's already jinking, so he'll continue jinking. We've got two crack grenades and one plasma. No, all miss. So, all right, moving on. All right, the main battle tank here is going to fire onto these guys here. So, see? Oops, scattered off, way off. Yeah. All right, and then the three snap firing heavy welders hits once. Strength 5? Nope, nothing. So they survive. Moving on. Demolisher! He's gonna fire onto these guys with his big old blast. So here we go. Roll for scatter. Yeah, direct hit. So that hits all four. So anything but. So we got four wounds, AP whatever.
Two.
Two, so got four plus cover saves. Lost two. Alright, so two go down. Alright, moving on. And he's gonna snap fire his bolt gun into them. And sixes. Oh wow. Wounding on threes. Got one. So one, three plus. Yeah, so he's good. Alright, keep on moving on. Alright, so the Bulgrin are gonna fire their blast into here. So first one scatters. Ooh!
Wrong way.
4 inches back. Does it hit him? Nope, just misses him. All right, next one. Direct hit, so that hits one or two? Two?
Two.
All right, and the third, that's gonna go way off. Yeah, that's not gonna hit anybody. All right, so we got two hits on them. So what's their strength on this?
Four, six.
Strength four, so looking for fives? Nothing. All right, so moving on. All right, Wyvern is gonna fire into these guys. Putting it right over there. So scatter, back, what is that? Back six.
Yeah.
All right, so that's gonna be way back.
Roll a couple of hits.
See what we can do.
Nope. One.
Maybe one. All right, so strength four.
Five. Nope.
Nope. Well, it's strength four?
Yeah.
They're toughness four. So that's four is a hit. That's a wound. So we got one wound. Three plus armor. They're good. All right. So they survived it. That's the end of the shooting phase for the Astra Militarum. We'll come back to you with charges.
Yep.
All right. The Bulgrin are going to charge into my bikes. So they've got Grim Resolve. So I've got Overwatch here. I've got the blacks are going to be rapid firing plasma guns, and the greens are going to be rapid firing bolt gun that are twin linked. So they're hitting on fives and sixes because of Grim Resolve.
One each.
This is twin linked. All right, so you got two. So toughness five. So I got fives on the green, twos on the black.
Good tie, then.
All right, so just the one AP two shot. So do they have an invul?
Nope.
So one of them takes a wound. Who's closest to the plasma guy? Or doesn't make a difference. I think it's just to the unit. So it might be this guy on the right end.
Yeah, so he's dead.
All right, so let's see what your charge, shouldn't affect your charge though. 6 inches. So I think, that's gonna be close, but I think it should be in. Oh yeah, they're in, they're way in. Sorry, my bad. That wasn't even close. What am I talking about? All right, so we'll move them in and then we'll come back to you with the actual assault. All right, so first thing we're gonna do here is the priest is gonna roll to try to give them re-rolls on to wound. So, and it goes off with four. So these guys, all of them are gonna get re-rolls to hit because of his zealot and re-roll to wound because of his prayers there. Brutal. So the Bulgrin here have Hammer of Wrath. So they've got two guys in base contact there. So we've got two hits, wounded on fours because they're strength five, toughness five. So you got one wound, AP dash, three plus, they're good. All right, so now we're gonna move into the fight sub-phase. What's your initiative on these guys?
They're low, two.
Okay, they're two. All of them are two, everybody's two?
Three, two.
Oh, three, three, two. All right, so my guys are gonna go first. So I will move in. I've got two base attacks. What's your weapon skill?
Four.
Weapon skill four, same as me, so looking for fours. Both hit. Toughness five, so wounding on fives. One wound. Three plus. And he saved it. Oh, no, is that cocked? Sorry. He still saved it. All right, so he saved it. So now we're going to move on to his attacks, which is where I think my bikes are just going to get brutalized here. All right, so we'll come back to you with that. All right, so coming in here on an initiative step three, we have the priest and the psyker. So we'll be hitting here. The grays will be the priest.
Grays are the priest.
Grays are the priest, blues are the psyker. So they all hit on fours, but the blues will be wounding on, they're at strength five, so they'll be wounded on fours. The others are gonna be strength four, or strength three?
Strength three,
so they're gonna be wounded on sixes. So, here we go, hitting on fours. All right, that's the one we wanted, though. So it's wounding on strength 5 to toughness 5, so 4. Nothing. All right, so now we move on to the Bulgrin. So there's one in there who's a bonehead. So he's going to have 5 attacks. The other guy has 4 attacks on the charge. So they're hitting on, what's their weapon skill?
5.
Weapon skill 5? So they're hitting on 3s. Oof, wow. All right, so now they're, and their strength what?
5.
Strength 5, toughness 5, so wounded on 4s.
Only 1.
All right. 3 plus? Nothing. All right, so one guy dies. All right, so you won combat, but I'm stubborn, so looking for 8. Yep, and we're still locked in. So this will continue on into the next round. Well, my turn's next. So I'm going to try hit and run. So now I have to do a initiative test, and I pass. So now I do 3d6, and I'm going to do 3d6 that way. Ooh, wow, 15 inches. So, yep, 15 inches this way. So he's going to be right there. Perfect. All right. So that's the end of the assault phase here. We'll move on to... we'll come back to you at the end of Dark Angel's movement on turn 3. All right, so movement phase for Dark Angels. These guys shot up here. These guys stood still. These guys stood still. Those guys stood still. He stood still. They actually failed their leadership test and ran back and then moved up this turn. He stood still. This guy came back over this way looking on these guys. These guys ran up. This moved up 6 inches and disembarked the unit there with my warlord in it. So hopefully you can start getting involved in some stuff there. So that's movement phase. We're going to move on now because of my dead psyker onto the shooting phase directly. So we've got these guys right here are actually going to fire into this tank right here. So I've got the rapid firing plasma gun and I've got the multi-melta. Those are the only things that can wound it on the side 13. So hitting on 3s. Of course the multi-melta misses. All right. Oh, that's a 1. So 3 plus. Nope, so he's going to die. He got one shot off, but so I need a 6 to glance. Don't get it. Well done, bikers. You suck. All right. Ugh. All right, moving on. All right, moving on to this bike over here. He's going to fire rapid fire his plasma into them. So hitting on 3s. Oh, God. Okay, so he's not dead, which is good. And wounded on a 2. That's a wound. 8B2. I think that's the closest guy, so I think he's dead. Yeah.
Dead.
All right. Well done. At least you didn't blow yourself up like your brother. All right, moving on. All right, we're going to move on to these guys. This plasma cannon is going to fire onto him here. I'm actually going to put it a little bit back, just like right there. Cool. All right. Gets hot. Nope. So scatter. Off 6 inches. That's going to be off on no one. All right. Do the same thing with this guy. Nope. Scatter, direct hit, and then we'll do on this guy. We'll just keep on going. Gets hot, nope. Scatter, it's off 2 inches, which I think should probably still hit. Yep. All right, so we got 2 wounds. Front armor is 13, right? Oh, front armor 12. So I'm looking for 5s to glance. Okay, nothing. All right, moving on. All right, now the whirlwind is gonna fire on to these guys, putting it right on there. So looking for a scatter, direct hit. So we should determine it was 6 in the back and then 3 in the front squad. So we'll do the 3 in the front squad first. So strength 4, AP 5, ignores cover. So look, wounded on 3s. So I've got 1 wound. So just one lookout, sir, because I think because the ordinance is that guy. And he looked out, sir, so just take out that guy. Cool, and then I've got 6. 6 on the other squad, winning on 3s. Oof, wow. Okay, 6 of them. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's right, 2 wound models, so take it off there. All right, so boom. Those guys are, the Warwind's doing pretty good. I like him. All right, moving on. All right, this squad here is going to fire into these guys. So I've got 3 rapid-firing bolters from the regular guys, 1 bolt pistol from my sergeant. I've got the black or the rapid-firing bolter from my dude. What's his face? His my company master. And then the red's going to be the melty gun. So All hitting on threes.
Nice.
All right. Or actually, he's hitting on twos, the company master. So, here we go. Wounding on threes and two. Of course, he goes that. All right. So I've got five wounds. I've got four plus cover saves.
These three.
Yep, sounds good. All right. And then one more for the guy there. Nope. And then I think that was it, right? Or one more? I think it was one more. I think it was five.
Saved.
So we're good. All right. So not bad. All right. So now I'm going to shoot the Storm Bolter in there. Hitting on threes. Wounding on threes. All right. So one more wound. Nope. Yep. That's that's a fail, right?
Yeah, that's a fail.
So he's dead. All right. So moving on in the shooting phase. Yeah.
Okay.
So these guys are going to fire into there. They're going to be snap firing because they move this turn. And they got a heavy weapon, so looking for sixes. No, nothing.
Turn that dice over.
Yeah. And then we've got over here, the sniper guy is going to shoot into them. So hitting on a flurry. Nope. Nothing. All right. I think that's the end of my shooting phase. I've got like a run maybe to do. And then I'm not going to do any charges. So I've got a run to do, and then I'll come back to you with the after movement phase for Astra Militarum on turn four. All right, so movement phase for Astra Militarum. These guys kind of moved up a little bit closer to him. These guys just all kind of conga lined along throughout the trenches. So that's the that's about all he did for movement phase. So the fight's starting to punch up a little bit more in the front here. So now we're going to move on to the psychic phase. He rolled a six. So we've got he's got nine dice. I've got six dice because my psyker's dead. So first we're gonna cast
Misfortune
onto these guys. So trying to get rending on them. That goes off with four. Ooh.
Without the perils too.
Without perils. I mean, I'm gonna try to deny it because I really think I need this. So looking for four sixes. Nope, just three. Oh, come on.
Wow.
These add up to six, right? Oh, so close. All right. So all shots on those guys are going to be rending. That's rough. All right. Next, he's going to roll a sail, which is a beam weapon. So he's going to try to cast it. How many do you need for this?
I just need one.
Just need one?
So that beam.
Yeah, that'll go through, hit two guys. Oh, it doesn't go off. Thank you. Thankfully, I needed that one. And then we're going to come on over here. And he's going to cast Prescience onto the main battle tank there. So needing two?
Nope.
Not getting it. All right. So not bad. Giving rending onto my Warlord unit over here. That's the end of the second phase. We'll come back to you with shooting phase and start with the orders. Starting the orders, these guys are going to try to give themselves first fire on my target. It goes off. These guys are going to try to get first rank fire, second rank fire. That also goes off. These guys are going to try to get fire on my target inside there. Goes off. And then these guys are going to try to get first rank fire, second rank fire. That goes off. Wow.
Wow.
Your orders have been really good so far.
Really well.
So that's the end of the orders part. So now we're going to move on to the shooting part of the shooting phase. All right, so the squad in there, which has fire on my target, is going to fire on these guys. So we've got rapid fire and plasma gun and a las cannon. So on threes. Ooh, that's plasma gun. He dead. Dies, so the plasma guy's dead, but one of his shots does hit. So, wounded on twos. That's a wound. Wounded on twos. That's a wound. And they got ignores cover, so I couldn't jinx. So, he's dead, and he'll take a wound. So, effective shooting. Pretty much worth, I guess, blowing yourself up. So, alright, moving on. Alright, so now the Chimera itself is going to fire onto these guys. So, we've got the green are the multi-laser, gray are the heavy bolter. So hitting on fours. All right.
So we need a five.
Five on this.
Nope.
Nope. And fours, threes on this, right?
Yep. So one.
So one.
Strength six.
Strength six, AP six, so three plus. And he's still alive. Woo! All right, moving on. All right, so now this squad is going to fire into this squad here. So they've got the first rank fire, second rank fire, so they got 26 shots with las guns going on. So we got the first 13 hitting on fours. Wow, nice.
That's a 12.
Yep. Oh, that's a 3 in there. There's a 3 in there. Cool. Yep.
Eight.
Yep. So now we got 8 first round. First shots, yes, go on. So we got 8.
So 14.
Yep, 14. So we got a total of 14 shots. So that was
one more.
Yep. All right, so we got, these are 14 shots. So the strength 3, toughness 4, so wounding on 4s, but 6s are rending. Oh, there's at least 2 rendings in there.
So 3 against 4, so we needed 5s.
Yes.
So 2 rends.
And 1 regular. All right, so I got 2 rends. Those guys are dead. Plus 1 normal, 3 plus save. And he's got it. So I just lost the 2 guys to the rending. But that's still pretty awesome.
Yeah.
All right, so moving on in the shooting phase. All right, this squad is going to fire into these guys. Same thing going on, but they got 18 shots. So these are all 18, hitting on 4s. All right, wounding on 5s. So we've got 3 wounds, 3 regular wounds. So I got 3 3 pluses. Still lost 2. All right, so that squad is getting whittled down. All right, moving on. Then we have 2 crack missiles going into these guys, so hitting on 4s, missing. So that's that for that squad. All right, moving on to the shooting phase. All right, so the squad inside the bunker there are gonna fire onto these guys here. So needing 4s, that's 2, nothing. Okay, that was 2, that's a plasma shot. So armor, nope. So the plasma guy is dead. All right, I'll take them however they come. All right, moving on. All right, so this squad with the fire on my target, ignoring cover, is gonna fire the master ordnance over that way. So let's see. Oof, scattering kind of way off, right?
Yeah.
So let's see if it-
6 inches.
6 inches. Nope, not hitting anyone. All right, I'll take it. Last cannon. Nope, oh, that does hit, sorry, yep. And it wounds. So one guy dies. Boom. All right, moving on. All right, main battle tank is gonna fire on this guy's with his main battle gun. It's a hit, so yep. So it's 3. So I'll hit all 4. So strength 4.
Against 8.
Against 8, so anything but 1. 4 guys dead, because it's AP3. Boom. All right. So those guys are dead. Moving on. All right, you have to hit it still with that.
Correct.
So here we go. So he's gonna shoot his big old blast onto my guy right there. So that'll probably also hit those guys on there. So for scatter, oh, nope. That's gonna scatter the wrong way. So it'll save those guys at least. 4 inches might still, yeah. So it still hits the tank, but it saves those guys. So on the tank, it's ordnance. So strength 10, any, yeah, that's a pen. AP what?
2.
AP 2, so plus 1?
4.
So it's shaken. So it won't be moving and fire snapshots. All right, moving on. So the Ogryn is going to fire onto the back here. So that's scattering off. That's a hit.
Weapon skill 4.
Weapon skill 4. All right. Ballistic skill, though. I think he's
sorry.
3.
Ballistic skill 3.
So it's still only scattered an inch. He'll still hit.
Yeah.
So looking for a 6? Nope. So, but he'll still be able to charge.
Yep.
So that's what he was going for there. All right, moving on. Cool. Yeah. So these guys are gonna fire into there. So we got the crack grenade and the plasma, needing 4s. So 1 crack grenade and 1 plasma hits. Crack grenade doesn't wound. Plasma does wound, and it's AP2, so he's dead. All right, moving on. Now the Wyvern is gonna fire over there. So, is that a direct? Nope. So 3 inches, that's a hit.
And now we're over here.
Direct hit, that's 2. Save it that way, so it still hits the 2. 5 hits so far, direct hit, so another 2. So that's 7 hits on them. Ooh. So 7 strength 4 hits. All right, so needing 4s.
Rending.
4 on 4, and they're rending.
And shreds.
6s, oh, and shreds. Ooh. So needing 4s. Reroll for shred. All right, so we got 1 rend and 4 regular. All right, so we got the 1 rend, and then we've got the 4 regulars. Four three pluses.
Oh, there.
Yeah.
Now the roll shows up.
Yeah, that's how you do it. That's how the company commander shows you how you do it. All right, and I think that's it for the shooting phase for Astra Militarum, so we'll come back to you with the assault phase. So these guys need a 7-inch charge to get into there. So seven, no, so they didn't make it in. All right, so that's the end of Astra Militarum turn four, so we'll come back to you after a movement phase for Dark Angels on turn four. All right, so movement phase, these guys shot over this way, looking at this, looking at these guys. These guys ran up, my company commander joined this squad over here. He couldn't move, he didn't want to move, and everyone else just kind of stood where they were. So moving on to shooting phase, because my Psyker is still dead, he's going to fire his heavy flamer on these guys. So he's going to hit six of them. So we've got six dice here. Strength five, toughness three, so wounded on twos. So that's six dead. It's AP five, or AP four, whatever it is. AP five, I think. So six dead. Wow, that was brutal. All right, now we're going to move on to this guy. I'm going to fire the multi-melt into the back of his gun there. So hitting on a three.
Wow.
Oh,
wow.
Come on.
Where's your Space Marine rerolls?
All right, moving on, because you failed me again. All right, so this squad's going to fire on these guys. The front guy's a flamer, and he can get three guys. So strength four, toughness three, wounding on threes. All right, so one dead.
Look out, sir.
He's going to look out, sir, onto that guy there. Yep, so someone else died. All right, then we've got... I'm going to fire two bolt pistols there from those guys. So hitting on three and two. Red will be the company commander. All right, wish it was the other way around. And that doesn't wound. Oh, yep, nope, that doesn't wound. All right, so moving on. All right, this guy is going to rapid fire his plasma gun into those guys. So hitting on threes, both hit. Wounding on twos, both wounds. AP two, so he takes two wounds. Front guy there. All right, moving on. Last kind of guys are going to fire into them. Hitting on threes. All right, one hit, wounded on twos. That's a wound. So you're going to look out, sir. It'll go on to your Bulgrin guy, so he'll die if you want to do that.
No, but...
Oh yeah, so you get five plus. Through cover?
Nope.
Nope, so he's dead. All right, so that's effective. Moving on. Sniper guy into these guys. So hitting on four. That's a precision shot. Who do I want to kill? I think I'm going to go for the Psyker guy. So wounded on a four. It's a wound. He can look out, sir, if you want.
Yep.
Gonna look out, sir?
Got it.
You got it. So, Bulgrin guy. And because, Bulgrin guy takes it. So, boom. All right. That was pretty good. All right, moving on. All right, these guys. Plasma cannon is gonna fire onto this guy there. So, first gets hot. Does not get hot. So, scatter. That's a direct hit. And this guy is gonna do the same thing. So, gets hot. Doesn't get hot. Scatter. Ooh, that's going off 6 inches. I don't think that's hitting anyone. Nope. So I just got the one hit. So one hit. What's the front armor is 12. So looking for 5 to glance. Hey, a pen. Plus one. That's a 6. It's immobilized. It was already immobilized. So all right. So it's a.
Wreck.
Oh, it's a wreck anyway. So we'll figure that one out and come back to you. Okay, these guys emergency disembarked, but they're pinned. They failed their leadership test. So that's where they are. And I think I've just got the one more thing. So moving on in the shooting phase. All right, Whirlwind. It's going to fire over this way. Wait, I got it. It's going to hit 8 guys if I get a direct hit. Use a direct hit. No. Minus 4, so it's going to be 3 inches that way. So it's still probably going to hit 4 guys, 5 guys? 5 guys. So... here we go. Strength 4, toughness 3. Looking for threes. All right, so 3 guys dead because ignores cover. All right, boom. That's cool. All right, that should be the end of the shooting phase. Moving on to the assault phase. All right, so these guys here are going to charge these guys here. So we've got 7 lasgun shots for Overwatch. Hitting on sixes. Got 2 hits. So wounding on fives. 1-2 wounds. All right. 2-3 pluses. Oh, one guy dies.
Huge.
Okay. So Is that the all of them? So now we have the charge distance, which we're right here. So 8. I think that should be enough to get them in. So we'll move them into combat, and then we'll do, yeah, that's plenty. So we'll move them into combat, and then we'll come back with the fight sub phase. All right, so the company master challenged and was accepted with the sergeant there. So he's at initiative 5, and my sergeant's at initiative 4, but his guys don't go initiative 3. So I'm going to roll them anyway together. So I've got the greens are going to be my company master. He's got 3 base, plus 1 for extra close combat weapon, plus 1 for the charge. And the sergeant has 1 base, 1 for the charge, 1 for extra close combat weapon. They do have assault grenades, so they didn't lose their initiative on charging through cover. So I'm hitting on, what's your weapon skill on these guys?
3.
So they're both hitting on, I've got to check that. Hold on 1 second. All right, so it's 3. They're both hitting on 3s. So looking for 3s. All right. Ugh. All right. Strength 4. Toughness 3. So wounding on 3s. All right. So that's the sergeant is just dead because it's AP 3. And then the two other guys and that squad can take their saves. One guy saves. So one more dead. All right. So now you'll pull in and then attack on me. All right. So now they're going to strike back. We've got 4 hits from the regular guys and then 2 from the psyker. So hitting on 4s. All right.
Strength
3. On toughness 4. So 5s. One wound there. And then 5 on 4. So 3. Nope. So I've got 1 save to make. 3 plus. Nope, he's dead. All right, so you lost by 1, right?
Yep.
So what's the leadership of your
9.
Psyker at 9? So now you need an 8. Oh, they're running. So now we have an initiative off.
Sorry, he is 9.
He is 9.
He's 9.
Minus 1, though, it's an 8.
Right.
Yes. So, yeah, so he's down there. So now we have initiative roll off. Initiative 5. 7 plus 3 is 7, so I caught you.
Yep.
So they're all dead. All right, that was really good there. So I will consolidate him, and then that'll be the end of Dark Angel's turn 4. Move on to Astra Militarum. We'll come back to you after movement on Astra Militarum turn 5. All right, movement phase for Astra Militarum. He moved back a bit. These guys came out of the bunker so they can shoot. These guys backed up away from my company master here. He pulled back so that it didn't give him any cover. He turned around. I mean, he's going to be taking a lot of hits. Let's see if he can save them all. So that should be it for movement phase, really. So now we're going to move into the psychic phase. He rolled a 3, which gives me 3 dice. And he has 2 psychers that are still alive. So that gives him 5 dice. So now we'll move on to the psychic phase. What's first?
Let's do the sail.
All right. It's going to do a sail over this way. So what do you need?
1 charge.
1 charge. So it goes off with 1. I'm going to try to deny it. Nope, not denied.
So strength 6 beam weapon.
Strength 6, toughness 5, so looking for 3. That hits. So is it AP 3?
Nope, just.
Okay, so 3 plus. He's good, yeah. All right, moving on. All right, he is going to cast prescience on that tank there. So needing 2.
Got it.
Got it with 2, so it's prescienced. All right. And then we're going to move on. That's the end of the psychic phase. Now we'll move on to the shooting phase and start with orders. So he's going to cast fire on my target here. That goes off. And then first ring fire, second ring fire on those guys. That also, yes, goes off. All right. So those were successful. Now moving on to the shooting part of the shooting phase. All right. So these guys are going to shoot into him. You got 17 lattice shots because of first ring fire, second ring fire, and then 2 crack missiles hitting on 4s.
Not good.
Not good. Both crack missiles miss, which is nice for me. Wounded on 5s. So we got
4
hits. Or 4 wounds, rather. So 4 3 pluses. Alright, he makes all but 1. So he's down to 2 wounds. Alrighty. Moving on. Alright, he's going to fire his flamer onto him. So it's toughness 4, 5, so looking for 3.
No.
Nope. Does not wound. All right, moving on. All right, Wyvern is going to fire the rest of his shots on him. Direct hit.
Got him.
So,
1.
So wounds over, so that misses. So, 1 so far.
2.
2. So just two. Two shots, strength four, toughness four, so looking for fours. Two wounds. Two, three plus saves. Takes another wound. Down to one. All right, moving on. All right, this squad here is gonna fire into him, looking for two crack grenades. Hitting on fours. Wounding on twos. No, okay, still alive. Hold on for the lion. All right, moving on. All right, so in here, this squad is gonna fire. We got two rapid firing plasma guns. Hitting on threes. Both hit. Oh, one hit and one gets hot. And he's dead. So one of the plasma gunners is gonna be dead, but then these are wounded on twos. So that's three wounds. He's got an iron halo. So I've got a four plus invul.
Come on, baby.
You can do it.
One.
Four plus, three, four pluses. That's all I'm looking for. No! Slay the warlord. Well done. It took a lot of shots, but it did, it killed him. So, all right, moving on in the shooting phase. All right, the battle tank. It's gonna fire my last cannon guys back there. Scattering, way off, five. Not hitting anybody. All right, so moving on. All right, this guy is gonna fire his plate onto there.
Missed.
So, now the heavy bolter is snap firing. Guts one.
Five.
Yep. One wound. Three plus. No, he's dead. He avoids the giant blast, but he dies to heavy bolters. All right, moving on. All right, these guys are gonna snap fire into the attack bike. Yep. So he's gonna jink. So hitting on threes. Oh, hitting on sixes because they're snap firing because they were pinned.
Last cannon.
Nothing. So I shouldn't have jinxed, but I did. Oh well, all right, so moving on. All right, so that's actually the end of the Astra Militarum turn five, so now we'll come back to you with the movement phase for Astra Militarum on turn five. For the Dark Angels on turn five. All right, so movement phase for Dark Angels. These guys moved up, these guys moved up. Over here, just one guy moved so he can get line of fire. He didn't move. He shuffled around looking on them. He moved up this way, looking on those guys. And he just kind of stayed where he was. So don't have a psyker still, so we're gonna move on to the shooting phase. He's gonna snap fire into the back of him. So he's got a rear of 10, so the bolters can actually hit. So the green will be the bolters snap firing, the black will be the multi-melta. All hitting on sixes. Yes, that's what I needed. That's what I needed. Reroll, didn't need that. All right, so I got six on the green, and then I've got looking for anything but snake. Yeah, it'll be whatever. So that's a pen, and that's not a glance. So pen plus two, because it's AP one. Boom, immobilized, it's already immobilized. So that's two hull points, it's a wreck. That's what I needed, woo! All right, I needed that real bad. All right, moving on. All right, so he's gonna use heavy flamer into this group. So he gets six. So looking for anything but, right? Yep, twos. Okay, so I throw a whole bunch of butt. Four guys there. So the first four guys, because it's closest, are dead.
Four.
Yep, so they're all dead. All right, moving on. All right, gonna fire the storm bolter into his psyker there. So hitting on threes. Get one, wounding on, what's his toughness?
Three.
Three, so wounding on threes. One wound.
Five up.
He's got it, nice. All right, moving on. All right, so he is gonna fire onto him. So looking for a four, don't get it, of course. It fell off the table 2 seconds ago and was a six, so that's what I get. So moving on. All right, my last cannons are firing into his tank over here. One of the guys moved, which is gonna be the black one, so he's snap firing. The other guy didn't move, so he's hitting a full. So looking for a six and three. Okay, one hit. Front armor 14. So five is a pen, as a glance, six is a pen. Nothing. All right, so moving on. All right, my whirlwind is gonna fire on these guys. So looking for no scatter. Hit. Direct hit. So we got five guys in that squad, plus two guys in this squad. So here's the five, looking for threes. Okay, four guys from that squad over there, It's ignores cover. And then two, and one from this squad. Three, and it's a three. So one guy from that squad dead. I think it's ordnance, so it's from the middle, so. He's dead, he's dead, he's dead, and he's dead. Cool. All right, so I think that's the end of the shooting phase. I think I got some runs, but those are boring to watch, as I've said before. So we'll come back to you, and no charges. So actually, do you want to roll off? I think that's the end, so we'll see. So on a 3+, it goes on. It doesn't, so that's the end of the game. Astra Militarum, we determined it before. They won. So it wasn't a complete victory because they lost a whole lot of people to their defense forces, but they were able to repel the first wave, at least, of Dark Angels. So I think the Dark Angels that are left are probably going to pull back and regroup, and maybe we'll revisit this planet again and see what happens. So that was an excellent game. Thank you to my opponent, Colin. And hope you enjoyed it. So yeah, if you like it, share, like, and subscribe the video. I've been Phil Hall, the Glacial Geek, and until next time, have a great one. Bye.